Under the project, water was pumped for a distance of 25 kilometers long from the hills of Mount Rwenzori in Karangura sub-county to the target beneficiaries in Renjaju sub-county. Minister Rusoke explained the sole aim of the water project.
Many people in Renjaju are complaining, and these are the complaints, and you shall find out if I'm wrong or if I'm right. One, you are complaining of the charges of 6,000 per month. Two, you are complaining that during the dry seasons, you don't get water the way it should come. The president's target objective is full-time production throughout the year, from 1st January up to 31st December. And his target is not to leave anyone behind.
Minister Soke maintained the need for value for money for the successful actualization of the Renjaju Presidential Model Sub-County.
You get the meaning of the word model. Yes, he's not going to do it throughout the country, but if he chose a model, it's for other people to learn from. Come and learn and hear testimonies and see physically the transformation of the availability of water for production from the time the scheme was done is the issue of value for money. Because, to the best of my knowledge, the sprinklers are not operational, they are not working. That's why he chose, he saw the problem and he used his local wisdom to make these. Let us, we are Ugandans, we are tasked to get value for money. This is not being besieged or suffocated. It is the effort of the president, and that's what we are focusing on.
Minister of State for Water, Honorable Aisha Sechinde, advised farmers to convene a meeting and harmonize on the water user fees that are affordable for all.
At least in my ministry, I recommend to them, we have done our work. What is remaining? The quotation, Mama, my sister, was talking about. Let us sit together as the chairperson requested. Let us sit together, different ministries, so that we can do, that each ministry can do its part. What is remaining here? What is making people complaining? It is the work for Ministry of Agriculture. The biggest part of it. We are not supposed to make those expansions to those remaining farmers. It is Ministry of Agriculture, because in the morning we said that our work according to the irrigation policy is to reach the water at gate, which we did from the other source where we went to different tanks or dams.
According to Richard Rabuhinga, the Kabarole district chairperson, the water project currently benefits over 300 farmers.
This was a Ministry of Water and Development funded project. It was not a district funded project, nor a delegated service. It is the minister that procured the contractor. It is the minister that paid the contractor through the basis. But the contractor and the consultant were so good that we turned through the whole project span with monthly site meetings.
Story compiled by Roger Sande for the news.